without thinking the way they acted, you know, and what effect it would have on us, you know, all three of us growing up. And now they're totally cool. You couldn't ask for better parents, but they were out of control.
Hey, how the hell far away is this marsh now?
Well, it's coming up.
This is a sound for the woods, and it's gonna totally suck. That's a cut because there's not one fucking bird. All I hear are trucks. I'm gonna have to go to Kettle Moraine or something like that. So there's absolutely nothing recorded for Pike Lake.
Hi, Mark.
Hey, Mike.
My mom packed us a lunch.
Did she? Oh, that's cool.
Yeah, we got polar sausage, cheese and crackers, and other stuff.
Good to see a smile on your face. How you doing?
Well, sir.
We're gonna do this by the numbers now. We gotta do a little sound recording. Tell them we have to do it now.
Yeah, all right. Yeah, okay. Yeah, bye-bye now.
Okay, thanks a lot, Ma. We'll see you around one. Yep, bye-bye.
Okay, we gotta do one line for the film. No one can hear you say, it's all right, it's okay, there's something to live for, Jesus told me so.
When am I gonna eat my dinner here?
Can you give him some cheese and crackers? Can we get the man something to eat so we can record this this one bit of dialogue here?
Oh, nuts.
Try a piece of this.
Oh, that's good stuff.
Yeah.
Don't have a damn thing to drink either.
Here, Bill.
Get him a soda, Mike.
Okay. Here you go. Here's a soda, Bill.
Oh, thanks.
Don't spill it. That's brand new soda from Coca-Cola. It's called Surge.
It's the first line of the film, man. It's got to be on the money here.
Roll down the window, Bill.
It's all right.
Okay, cut. All right, man. Shit.
You gotta give it some passion too, man. And you gotta, it's all right, it's okay. There's something to live for. Oh. Jesus told me so.
It's all right. There's something to live for. Jesus told me so.
Okay, great, Bill, but we have to have fluidity in there.
It's all right, it's okay.
Okay, cut. You gotta bring passion to it, a message, it's a message.
For the shits and for the birds. This is for the birds.
Okay, I believe we can do this. I believe this can be done, Bill. Hey man, Mike, why don't you keep track of what takes these are, man? Is this fucking take seven? Okay, let's do take seven, man.
It's all right. It's okay.
Cut. Okay. You have to believe in what you're saying, Bill.
You do? Well, I don't. I don't believe nothing what you're doing.
All right. Give it some passion. It's all right. It's okay. There's something to live for. Jesus told me so. You did it before. You could do it again. Okay, this is take eight.
It's all right. It's okay.
Okay, that's fine. You gotta watch your teeth too, because they clack a little bit when they loosen up in the mouth. And take 10.
It's all right. It's okay. It's something to live for. Jesus told me so.
Bill, you couldn't ask for anything better. I think it was recorded too high. Give it all you got. What take is this?
16.
This is take 16. Let's go. Take 30.
All right.
Hold up. Take 30.
It's all right. It's okay. This Jesus told me so. There's something to live for.
Okay. Cut. Take 31.
So is that enough now?
No. Listen, Bill.
I ain't gonna do this anymore. That's all for me. Goodbye.
Okay. I'm gonna see what we have to work with. Jesus Christ, man.
And it's like the whole room is just filled with this thick green and red web, you know, and it's coming out of Lauren, and it's coming out of the table, and it's coming out of the walls, and it's coming out of the floor, you know. And all of a sudden, my face hit the table, you know, and I blacked out. So Laura dragged me outside and laid me on the grass, you know, hoping I'd wake up, you know. And then her grandma came home, who she lived with, you know, and her grandma called an ambulance, you know. So I'm laying in the hospital, passed out. They got my brain on a brain scanner, and you know how your brain is supposed to go beep, 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 beep? Well, I just went straight across, you know. And the doctor goes to my mom, he goes, I don't think your son is going to make it. Sorry, you know, I think he's going to die, you know. I don't think there's any way we can bring him, you know, wake him up or nothing, you know. So all of a sudden I smell this real strong smell, and it's smelling salts they got in front of my nose, and I start to wake up, and all I see is bright lights, and I'm like, damn, where the hell am I, you know. And then I realize I'm in the hospital, so I start checking my pockets for the acid, which they analyzed one hit. It turned out to be a blotter paper dipped in liquid PCP with a little bit of Downer in it. And they said if it hadn't have been for that little bit of Downer, I would be dead. But anyways, I'm checking my pockets for the acid, you know, because I was going to drop my other three hits in the hospital, you know. And all of a sudden, my mom walks in the room, and she's holding a bag of acid like this, you know. I'm like, damn, you know, now I can't drop it, the rest of my acid in the hospital. So she flushes it down the toilet, you know. And then they kept me in the hospital another month, and they said I was the worst case they ever had. And they let me go, and I continued using drugs all the way up until a little under a year and a half ago. And that's I have more stories like that I could tell you too. All kinds of drug related stories. I could tell you, you know. So I'll try and keep you awake with him tonight.